Hello, and welcome to Let's Play Hammerfight with me, 1F Jeff. This game is made by Konstantin Koshutin, and it is a beautiful indie gamer platformer thingy. It's difficult to describe. In fact, it's something that I think needs to be demonstrated and not described, so I'm not going to spend a great deal of time talking about it, as per instead of, for example, showing it to you. That made no sense. It's based around a very simple mechanic that on glance looks to be repetitive, but if you can stick around for a minute, I'll show you why it's not and why you should definitely check this game out. It's extremely satisfying to play, and the mechanic is quite varied, but the basic mechanic is spinning around in circles and smashing things with a hammer. Now, if you have a problem with that, you should go away, because there's going to be plenty of it. So, let's make a new game. We will be named Smash Your Face Guy. That's me. There we are. This is me. This is you. This is us. We are a little, well, not really little, fairly large, wooden, steampunk-ish flying machine with a helicopter blade on top. Our banner floats above our head, and our weapon floats below our ass. In this case, it is a stone mace on a chain. There are many weapons in this game. This is only one of them. This is the one you begin with. This is the story of you, me, we, a Gaiar, I believe I'm pronouncing that correct. One of three tribes. This is in the earliest times, people had been finding broken machines. That's a machine we're flying. The vaults of the abyss. Machines that with skillful hands could be made to fly. They discovered that there was no task under the sky which these machines could not be useful. So, whether in times of war or peace, those who could control the machines received the most honor. That's us. We're the honor ones. Since the creation of the world, there had always been three families, three houses to rule over the abyss. The name of the first was Kadish, the second was Kelit, and the third was named Gaiar. For many generations, all people were equal, and there was peace between the nations, and so it might have remained. Had the sixth senere of Gaiar not been overcome by pride and thought himself to be the greatest of his brothers, and through murders and great bloodshed established his rule over his kin. Thus was the first kingdom founded, into which I don't think we're going to be entering. Anyway, there's our teacher. Perhaps it's time to show you how to operate this machine. Do show. I believe I have a good smashing feeling coming on. Hopefully we'll have a smashing good time. Maybe we can hammer out the kinks. Oh, I'm going to have so many great puns. I found a suitable opponent. So these are the controls. There you go. That's it. That's all of them. You wiggle the mouse around and you hit things with your hammer. There's a little bit more to it. I'll get into more detail. There's various, slightly more technical issues. Now, I'm going to try to hit Kalim with my mace. So, there we go. Our mace is spinning, but it's not spinning fast enough. We want to spin it really, 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 really fast, and then crack! Give him a good... Oops, I broke your house, guys. I'm sorry. Another neat ow thing about this ow game is that one, I'm not very good at it. Two, it has incredible, destructible environments and terrain. Like this guy's house. And I will see if I can, use this guy's house to strike Kalim. Okay, I can't. But you get the picture, right? You can... Oh, I almost had you. You can use objects in the environment like that to influence the outcome of a fight. So, really cool technologically, and obviously, I think it's beautiful, the style is fantastic, and the gameplay is really fluid and very fun. So, we're going to be into a fight. I'm not going to read all this text. Obviously, you can read, I think. I'll read some of it, the important parts. Mostly, I'll just respond to it. Anyway, we're in a fight, and it's not a fight to the first hit, as I've just demonstrated. It's a fight to knock the other one unconscious by smacking him into things or failing. And the idea is to hurt him but not kill him. Oops! I killed him. My bad! I hit him in the spikes and he died. Oops, I skipped those. Akil has shown up. Greetings to the chief. He's the chief, obviously. My old friend, you decided to teach this guy R? I guess it could be gay R's? I don't know. Let me show him a lesson. At dawn tomorrow, I'll lead you in a hunt. No, you won't. The worms of Veles are slow, yet the carelessness of heaven allowed them to multiply beyond reason. See why I won't be reading all this stuff? Look, he's talking, his lips are moving. Just, you know, read his lips. Okay, so basically what's going on here is one of them wants to take me on a hunt of dangerous worms, and the other one wants to take me to go hang out with some... Yeah, the Hunter's Contest. He wants me to go join the Hunter's Contest. This is the first of many decisions that we will have to make in the game that influence the course of events that our journey will take. Now, if this is your first time playing through it, I do not recommend you do the hard one. It says hard on it for a reason. It's extremely fucking hard. I can't do it. I'm not that good. So we're gonna do the other one. Sorry. It's also the hard one's also the only way to unlock Grim mode, which is another game mode. There's Arena and Grim mode. There might be more, I don't know. I think that's it. But it's sort of like a worm hunt where you hunt for glory and money. Anyway, this is the level pass screen, where it shows us how much fame we've earned, how much money we got for it, our overall rating, I have no idea what that means, and then our number of glory, which is basically our overall, like, respect or whatever in the world. The family of Saadi was one of the smallest in the large Kaddish family. For centuries, they had kept friendship with the Gaiars, thus were held in low esteem by the Arguseed throne. Their territory was at the very western point of the archipelago, where they made a living from hunting, like their neighbors, and sometimes by trading worms. The goods were highly valued by the caravan masters of Melkala. Cool. Cool story, bro. Let's smash more things with hammers. Good day to you, giant Melak, or whatever. Good day, my friend. I haven't heard your voice in ages. What has brought you to our land? This young warrior. Oops, I skipped that. The hospitality of your people is known... I didn't know it. Yet I would like to request that you allow me to participate in the Hunter's Trial. Aren't you too young for this, friend? Ah, yes, giant. Young he is. Yet trust me, I brought him to you for a reason. Well, here's my son, Cassie. Kill him. I mean, demonstrate to us that your mace skills are no worse than his, and we will allow you to undergo the trial. He doesn't even have a mace. He's got a hammer. I wonder if I could steal his hammer. I want your hammer, bro. Give me your hammer. So yeah, this is the gist of the fight style and mechanic. I'm taking my time here, because I want to see if I can snag his hammer. Come up here. You can taunt them by wiggling yourself around, and it will sometimes make them do that. Essentially fly into a rage. Oh, I... Almost... Aw. Oh. I got his hammer, but ow! Thud. It smacked me on the head, and I couldn't steal it. Melkala Melchan, the great house guy, gives birth to a large number of warriors. I bet my beard, ew. How would you even collect on a beard bet? Can you imagine the cashier at a casino? I'd like to cash in these hairs, please. No. I don't think so. That's disgusting. Now at your disposal is Stone Mace. Sadly, we already had one of these. But essentially what it does is it unlocks it in another area of the game called the hall, the training hall, where you can stockpile weapons that you either take from other warriors or you keep or you earn through challenges and things like that. It's got its own stats. It's not very good, but it's ours, and it smashes faces. So, Gaiar, I have to leave you. No, puppy! What will I do without you? I need to go to the Gaiar's cliffs immediately. I'm afraid there's grave news. I'm going to call him Puppy. Puppy! I don't know why. He's Puppy. This young warrior wishes to prove his right to be called a hunter. Who will test him? Yoink. Dibs. Okay, so now we have a hammer, and that guy is throwing Ow! Oh god, get away! Ow! Oh, I'm not off to a good start! Ow! Here. Who's the one I'm fighting? Taunt them. It's you! Okay. There we go. Oops, sorry, Teach. Didn't mean to smack your friend into you. Or accidentally hit your house. Come on, wake up. Wake up, jackass. Oh. Gotta get him down here so I can smack him into the wall. Come on. Yeah, Ave, whatever. Oops. Ow, 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 ow. You have to be very careful not to hit them with your body. There we go. I'm gonna steal his hammer. Now I've got two hammers. You know what that means? I don't either, but I've got two of them, so it must mean twice as much or something. His hammer is poisoned right now. I think think I accidentally threw my second hammer. Oh no, alas, you were... Lick the hammer, just goes flying up. Yeah, I smacked myself into his hammer and I died. So that happens a lot. Welcome to your first death. There will be more. And so let's recover quickly and dispatch this guy. And hopefully we won't have too many more in this relatively easy encounter. One down, defend your face. Oops, sorry, teacher. My head! What are you doing over there? Oh, he's just waiting for me to smack my head into the... He's stealing his friend! Come back! Whoa! Bingo! So I think I have to defeat three of them. That's two down. Come at me, bro. What you got? You ain't got no hammer? That's more like a... You're a Nerf hammer. It's tough to taunt a wooden propeller-driven helicopter hammer thing. Like, where do you even start with that? Come on. What are you doing? Aren't you supposed to be fighting me? You just gonna sit there and wait? And hope that I screw up eventually, like you know I will? I guess that's actually a very good strategy. Sorry, teacher. He was laying on you. Nothing personal. Oh, I guess I have to fight more. And this one's got an axe. Fortunately, he's off to a rather bad start. He's also got shields on. A little... Oh, give me the axe! No! Oh, I wanted to steal his axe. Alright, hopefully I can steal this guy's axe. I'm thinking no, but... You know, maybe. Come on, bro. Axe me. Nope. Didn't get it. That was a good hit, but I hit his armor. I didn't break his armor either. Oh! I just smacked myself into the wall. This is not a fair fight! He's got armor! There we go. I knocked off one of his pieces of armor. And I knocked a piece of that piece of armor out of him. Ow! Just smacked myself into... Hey, what are you doing back? I thought I dispatched you. You guys are all pansies. You won't come at me. I guess it's because I'm spinning around like a freakazoid. Oh man, it's so tough to get used to these really short weapons once you've been using a long one for so long. Like me. Tiny dink, dink, dink. Is that the teacher in there? Oh hey, I won somehow. Where's his axe? I want it. Oh, he never dropped it. Give it to me. I need it. Oh, he's saying, not bad, you have the right to be called our... Oops, equal. Break a shield to prove it some more. Oh shit, maybe I shouldn't have broken his shields. Warriors of the Saiyati people, prepare yourselves for battle now, since I came to remind you of Cyrus's oath. I've been preparing for your coming all my life, Seneschal. Let's begin, then. Gaiar, run! Run away! They've got guns and swords and really long banners, which means they're very proficient at killing people like me. Little old me. Poor innocent little old me. Now at your disposal is a hammer. That's right, you don't start hammer fight with a hammer. You have to earn your hammer. It's because this game is hardcore, and we've earned the title of Hunter, which gives us a new banner. And we've got a new title. People will call you Smasher Face Guy, the Peacemaker. Mercifulness is a vivid character trait, and it did not go unnoticed by the crowd. I guess killing my first opponent on accident didn't get me a title. Whatever. Didn't get a rating, I don't know what that means, but... Blow up the docks, let nobody escape! Uh-oh. Help us, my friend, so I'm supposed to protect the docks here. Cover the worms, or else we won't live to see the sun. Okay. Gotcha. Worm covering duty. It's a little tiny robot, and I've got my... Ow, get off me! These guys are trying to kill our worms, and I don't want them to. Freaking buzzsaw jerks. I should probably be hitting them the other way, away from the docks and the worms that I'm supposed to be... Died. That was bad from go, so let's pretend that didn't happen, and off we go again. Okay, spinning this way. There we go. Next. I said, I think that one that I hit in the... Dang it. I thought that one was alive, but I guess not. Oh, I wanted a double kill. Oh, I got a double kill there on accident. I guess it's not really a double kill. They're just little stupid buzz saws, but ow. My face, bro. I accidentally smashed you with it. You're screwed. What? Heavens, we can't linger any longer. I guess the timer ran out. Gear, 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 gear. I'll skip most of these scenes. It doesn't really matter. I mean, it does, but, you know, we don't need to count each one. The refugees' caravan was moving away from the smoke of conflict. The drivers showed no mercy to the worms, hoping to outrun those chasing them. Yet, as the sun was getting lower, people kept glancing with increased anxiety at the gunners who were standing ready to fire. So the worms that they're talking about, they're those blimp things. They're actually worms, the creatures I was sent to hunt, who've been tamed, I guess, domesticated maybe, and encapsulated in these wooden casings, and they sort of fly around. So they use them as, like, living blimps. Anyway, we'll see some in a minute. And I believe I'm supposed to protect them on this journey after I drink my soda. Because I'm an unprofessional Let's Player. Because who the fuck is a professional Let's Player? Seriously, bros. Riddle me that. The lights, my lord, they are getting closer. Fight. That was very vague. Whoa, rockets! Fortunately, I can hit their rockets, and this is one of the bad worms. It's all armored, and it's ow, ow, chainsaw. I can kill those, though. You have to kind of hit them right in the nose, like that, except I missed. There we go, got it. Oh, crap. Now, as far as my health and stuff, I suppose I should explain the interface a little bit. Maybe, you know, for those of you who care about how I just died there, for example. How did that happen? Well, if you look in the bottom left corner, you'll see that there's a little gauge. It starts out at everything is fine, and it slowly proceeds towards fucked. Or in the case of the last fight, rapidly proceeds towards fucked. So yeah, you can see the little worms' mouths moving in there, and they're articulated because there's a worm inside that thing, but that's their little worm propulsion technique. It's used by both the good guys and the bad. No, get that rocket away from my friends. The best thing I've found to do with these is not to hit the worm, because it takes a lot of hits. It's to hit the basket, or in that case, cause one of their own little robots to hit their own little basket. And I think they might have just, yeah, they blew up the basket from that worm. If you get a really good shot, yeah, there you go, I killed the worm in there. You can kill the worm. No, bro, no. Oh, dude, where am I? What happened? That guy's whole ship just got blown up. That sucks. Yeah, there you go. See? Just clock the basket, the worm will go. You don't have to worry about the worm. You can get it if you want to, like that. But, anyway. That's how it works. And we've got ally worms here, and they've got little gunners inside shooting guns. Get out of here, worm. You don't even have a basket. Ow. Jerk face. Oh, crud. I'm in trouble. Ow, I keep getting hit off screen by these machines. Ow! Oh my goodness! Get away from me, freaking buzzsaw! Okay, deal with the spinny thing and then with the crazy bad rocket shooting worm. There we go, I broke it. And then I hit it with my head. And I'm about to die, as I was saying about that whole gauge on the bottom left. Now you can't see it anymore, but it was, like one tick away from fucked. So what's left of the caravan will now go east. Probably could have done a little better, but I didn't. You know why? Because I'm me. That's why. Spoiler warning. So we killed 5 worms and 7 gears. Woo! That night, the last of the offspring of the glorious house leaders gathered at the foot of the Gaiar's cliff. Troubled by the news, they came to hear what the elders would decide. Little did they know that evening, the Cum had already decided everything for them. They're fucked. They're screwed. They are Hammerfought. Akil, the Emperor, won't leave our people in peace. He swore an oath to slay us all and leave no trace of the Gaiars under the sun. Today that oath nears its completion. My father, Chief Sayadi, was treacherously killed. And with my own eyes, I've seen the banners of the Emperor's fleet of Melka. Disaster at our door. Only together do we have a chance of salvation. I thought it was with hammers. Who can tell? However, what are you offering? Sayadi Cliff isn't... What? That's not an offer. He's gonna ask for permission to stay the night, and that jerk's gonna be all like, no. No, because I'm a jerk. But no. If these walls won't hide sheltered cowards. I'm not a coward, bro. I'm a hunter, and I'm the merciful, because, like, yeah. A ship. Faster, come on, faster. That's me. Well, I'm near them. Who are these travelers? Only a madman would dare to travel at this hour, even if he had an army all around him. Why? There's an enormous shadow over them. Sophet, the spirit of the night. Poor devils, they won't make it to the cliff. Ah, not if I have anything to say about it. Or probably even if I do have something to say. Ow! Yeah, because I'll probably just end up saying ow a lot, because it's going to tear me apart. This is the big scary demon beast. Oops, I just hit my own cart, and whoa! If I can avoid getting killed by this thing, then we can move on. But I'm hitting my own blimp, whatever the hell that thing is, as much as I'm hitting the bad guy. Come on. Suck it up, Sophet. Where'd you go? Whoa! Best strategy for Sophet killing, from what I can tell, is avoiding him until you have a really bad opportunity to strike. I thought he was going to go up, he went left. It's just, you know, it was never meant to be. Except, it is meant to be, this time. With me! What up, Jeff? What? Ow! Okay. Okay, it was not meant to be. My blimp and myself both were one-shotted instantly by the Sophet. Now that is something to be scared of. Okay, now, Sophet. Come on. Whoa! You missed us both, jerk. Jerk face. Come at me, bro. I taunted it. Hopefully it'll go after me and not the blimp. Okay, go after the blimp. Okay, don't go after the blimp. Get your little claw hands off me. Oh, I just want to cut heads on you, bro. You need to keep it near the light, because it's invisible in the dark and stuff. Okay, see? Avoided him, he lost momentum, and we got a good shot. Gotta keep our... You don't really need to keep your spinning up, but you never know when a strike like that's gonna present itself to... That was really dumb of me. Get myself tangled up in his little claw hands or whatever those are. Come on. I'm delicious. Oh, you're dead. He blew up inside. So there we go, a little Sophet 101. Now worms all like clickety clack. One. Only one thing, but it was a big one. From now on, you will be named Sophet Slayer. We're the Sophet Slayer. We slayed a Sophet. That night, the leaders did not sleep, and when the sun ascended above the cloudy ridge, the hearts of the brave trembled, for from the west and from the east, over all the borders of society, black smoke was rising. Scary shit, yo. Naven was right. The eastern outpost burned. In just an hour or two, we may see those who were sent to slay the Gaiars. Let's meet them the way that is befitting of warriors. Let us. Now it begins. Gaiar to arms! Okay, you guys go first. I'm gonna kill myself. Meant to do that. Yes, no, that was... It's all part of my strategy. Okay, calm, slowly. Okay. Okay, so they're robots. There's no... Yeah, I killed one. Oops, I hit my friend. Ow, 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 ow. I'm confused. Who's on my side here? There we go. Smacking him around. Whoa, someone threw a throwing dart. I'm gonna steal it. Yeah, I stole it. Even though they're useless to me. Can't hit anything with him. That is a bad guy, and now he's a very hurt bad guy. Okay, yeah, that was not cool. And they've got worms, so I will take out their little worm ships. I think I can tell the bad guys from the good because they don't have the right banners. No, that they don't even have banners at all. Okay, now what just happened here? I got a really good hit off on one of them, and so it went into sort of bullet time and allows me to swing faster, and then I stole his hammer. Which I'm probably going to end up just using as either a throwing weapon or a defensive weapon, because it's not all that useful to me. But I would like to keep it, I suppose, if it doesn't cost me the win here. Because, you know, that's why I'm doing it, for the win. Ow! Let's see if I can get a good hit on someone. Whoa! It's tough fighting with two unbalanced weapons of similar length. because they tend not to complement each other. Oh, that one got fudged up. Okay, so this is actually a decent combo. You can get all sorts of neat combos with weapons later on, but this one's, I guess, a little wonky. You are not that bad, Gaiar. My name is Hammer Safi Lakim. Put down your weapons. He knows I have two, and I will spare your life. Ow. Ow, ow. Ow. Why did that thing fall on me? Can't you see it? What? Believe me, Gaiar, it's not yet time for you to die. We'll see, you bastard. I'm like, it is time for me to die. Charge very slowly. I don't think I made it. I'm not sure. Who knows? Maybe I made it. Now at your disposal is machine hammer, cheaply forged but very heavy. A strange weapon from a cursed nation. You've earned the title of Nuker. Okay. And we got some fame and glory and stuff. Although affliction cometh not forth of the dust, neither doth trouble spring out of the ground, yet man is born unto trouble as the sparks fly upward. I don't know what that means, but there it is. Aww. Here they are like hay. The fire consumed them, and they didn't save their souls from the flames. Master, we are ready. Very well, order our departure. What shall we do with the young Gaiar? Cage him. We'll steal him in Melka. So there's our nation on fire. The Gaiars are no more. Chapter 2, Melka. The rule of the House of Gaiar lasted 7 years, whereupon the people rose against their kingdom and burnt it to ash. They chose a new king, a man from the House of Kadish, by the name of Basant the Arguseed, which means throne-worthy. Thus was the second kingdom founded, and the offspring of Arguseed reigned through the ages. At this time, House Gaiar was in lament. Enslaved by the other nations, they could not find a place for themselves on the earth, and many retreated into the depths of the abyss, for there they could live without fear of their neighbors. They penetrated into the mysteries of the abyss, exploring further than anyone else had done, and the abyss penetrated more and more into them. Oh, okay. They hunted beasts for food and found many strange gems in the bellies of their prey. They studied these gems and used them in the craft of war. They were truly a strange nation. That's us. We're weird. Who knew? Seems that everyone who walks beneath the stars will soon end up here in my hold, chained. Bummer. They're cute. They're adorable little people. If only I had my robot and I could smash them with my hammer. If the Emperor doesn't stop his something, it will probably be so. Yeah, his Senarahim. Those are his elite warriors, I guess. Until then, stop grumbling and get the goods. Give me the goods, yo! 6 warriors among them. And I'm the one in the cage there. Dangling. By the way, watch this one. Feed him and take care of him. I don't want him to become ill. He was quite a fighter, I'm told. You bet! Take him with me when I'm ready. Welcome to the port of Melka, last of the Gaiars. And thus ends, I believe, chapter 1. Or no, this is the beginning of chapter 2. And next time, we'll go into the slave pits, where we've been enslaved and they've taken our hammer. And now we can't smash things. With me, one of Jeff. I'll do these things, and I'll do Hammerfight, sort of like his bonus videos I'll tack on at the end of other sets. Probably not long videos, probably not in large number. It shouldn't take too long to finish anyway, but hope you like it. I love this game, it's a lot of fun, and I'm looking forward to finishing more playthrough and smashy stuff. So I'll see you then, unless I don't.